Well, welcome to the 700 Club. Another brutal cold wave is hitting much of the country, and it's bringing temperatures well below zero.
This freezing snow and cold is more than just uncomfortable. It's also dangerous. Charlene Israel has the story.
I don't even want to go out of the house.
Really cold.
It's like needles sticking in your face.
More than 100 million people are waking up in an icebox this morning. Wind chill advisories have been posted in 15 states from the Midwest to the East Coast. On Tuesday, the wind chill in Maine brought temperatures to 50 below. Around the Great Lakes, minus 40. And in North Carolina, 10 below. The extreme cold is already being blamed for at least four deaths. Blinding snow caused a 150-car pileup in Ohio. And people working outside, like construction workers, are at risk of hypothermia or frostbite.
Pretty quickly, you can start to experience symptoms of frostbite within 5 to 10 minutes of being outside.
Even inside, the cold temperatures can make life uncomfortable.
All the cold air from outside came in, got cold enough overnight with the low temperatures, and it simply froze the water service in the house.
You can't do anything. I mean, pretty much. You go to wash your hands, you can't even do that. Yeah, no coffee, no toilet, can't flush the toilet.
Meteorologists say the weather is likely to get even worse, with even colder conditions coming in by the end of the week.
This air mass that has set in from the plains all the way toward the Mid-Atlantic and the Northeast is some of the coldest air that we've seen in at least a couple of years.
High temperatures across the Midwest and Northeast are expected to remain below freezing until at least the weekend. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Well, if you're living in that cold, please stay inside and stay safe. Well, it may be cold in many parts of the country, but Secretary of State Hillary Clinton could be taking some heat on Capitol Hill today. Lee Webb has that story from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
Gordon, Mrs. Clinton facing tough questions about Libya today. She's finally testifying about the September attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi. Four Americans, including Ambassador Chris Stevens, died in the attack. Clinton postponed her testimony last month due to a concussion and blood clot near her brain. Republicans claim the Obama administration ignored signs of deteriorating security in Libya and refused requests for more security there. They also say the administration portrayed an act of terrorism as just protest over an anti-Muslim film. Israelis voted for a change in their government, but it wasn't the change most expected. Chris Mitchell reports on the surprising results of an election that saw the highest turnout in more than a decade.
As expected, Benjamin Netanyahu's combined Likud-Betanu party received the most seats, but center-left parties received more seats than anticipated. The results put Israel's center-right and center-left parties split down the middle at 60 seats apiece.
The big news of the evening was the emergence of Yair Lapid and his center-left party. It will have a major impact on how Bibi Netanyahu will be able to form the next coalition government.
But that's the big news. It's very much a kind of centrist picture. That's what's coming out here. That's what the Israeli electorate is looking like.
The results mean Netanyahu will likely be the next prime minister and form the next government. He goes into negotiations weaker than expected, but some believe Lapid can help him. Others are uncertain about what the next Israeli government will look like and how long it will last. With a divided electorate, some anticipate Israelis might be going to the polls again in the not-too-distant future. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Tel Aviv.
Gordon, back to you.
Well, after an election, you hate to be predicting that there'll be another election very quickly, but that's the parliamentary system, and if you can't hold your majority, you're back to the polls. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
It was the most angelic, the most
peaceful, safe, loving place.
I wasn't afraid.
There was not a feeling of time.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You just can't even imagine.
For years, Jim and Carolyn Parker lived on credit cards. The only financial plan they had was buy now, pay later. Well, that plan didn't quite work out, and the Parkers found themselves under a mountain of debt.
For a long time, Carolyn Parker had her own ideas about how God blessed people.
I was going to manufacture some prosperity by using my credit cards. You get goods and merchandise, right? And long as you can pay, this was his way. This is the windows of heaven being opened to me.
Carolyn and her husband, Jim, began tithing when they first married. They also used credit cards to get things they needed or wanted for their growing family. Their consumer debt reached $15,000.
It was kind of depressing because it put you down, because here you are, you're making plenty of money, but you don't have any money, you know, to do the things you need to do with, because it's all going to creditors.
One day, Jim and Carolyn got a wake-up call when they couldn't pay their mortgage on time. That's when they started watching Pat Robertson teach about a system to pay off their credit cards.
Pat said, go to the smallest one and then take that amount and go to the next one. Take that amount and go to the next one. And that's what I did.
The Parkers put that lesson into practice and started to aggressively pay down their credit card debt. They also joined the 700 Club.
I love what they do. When I look at the 700 Club and the wells that they build, the Orphans Promise, Operation Blessing, the gospel is going out over the airwaves.
The Parkers finally paid off their credit cards, and not a moment too soon. Carolyn's company decided to leave the state where they lived, and she was left without a job. The company paid her an entire year's salary as part of her severance package.
That was a blessing because there were people that were being fired with nothing. And the second thing was, I didn't have any debt.
Today, Jim and Carolyn are retired, and they say they have found peace as they've learned to trust God with their finances.
God is able to supply, and He's able to give you more than what you could ever give out.
And you may be like Jim and Carolyn, and don't for a minute think your position is hopeless. You can get out from a mountain of debt, but what you need to do is a little plastic surgery where you take those cards and cut them up and then say, okay, if I don't have the cash, I'm not buying it. And then do just what Jim and Carolyn did. Pick the lowest one and start paying that off. And once it's paid off, then add that payment into the next one. And once that's paid off, add that payment into the next one. And over time, you'll find that you can get out of debt and you avoid the trap that the Bible warns about, that the borrower is the servant of the lender. Now, when you start to live life the way God wants you to do, you run into this wonderful promise from Psalm 128. How joyful are those who fear the Lord, all who follow His ways. You will enjoy the fruit of your labor. How joyful and prosperous you will be. That is the Lord's blessing for those who fear Him. Resolve in 2013 that you're going to do it God's way. When you do it His way, then you run right into the promises that He has for you, that He wants you to be joyful. He wants you to enjoy the fruit of your labor. Well, when Jim Freeberg got laid off, he spent the next 2 years trying to find work. Then one day, Jim's wife gave him some advice that got him 2 job offers the very next day.
Jim Freeberg and his wife Janet enjoy their life together in Colorado's high country. Jim has always had steady work in construction, but after almost 30 years, he was laid off when the recession hit.
I just hadn't anticipated that I would be in that spot in my life.
Janet staged homes going on the market and took a hit too. The couple went through their savings and started cutting corners every way they could. Jim searched for a job, but came up empty.
There was no apparent relief on the horizon.
Friends and family helped them get by.
There was provision, but it was humbling provision.
And then Janet had a breakthrough.
The Lord woke me up one morning with Psalm 23, verse 1. He leads you, He guides you, He feeds you. It was no longer the job is my provision. It was He is my provision.
Janet and Jim decided to trust God. They tithed off the money people were giving them and continued partnering with CBN.
Every time that we would tithe, the Lord was faithful to get us to the next spot.
For 2 years, the Freibergs continued to have just enough money to pay their bills every month, but Jim was still frustrated.
I would say, I don't think the construction industry will ever return. Janet made a suggestion to me, you know, maybe what you've been saying about the construction industry, maybe you've been, in effect, cursing yourself with your own words. And so I asked the Lord to forgive me for the words that I had spoken and to give me a second chance.
A few weeks later, the couple heard a message on declaring the Word of God.
We drove to a nearby mountaintop. We read God's promises over us, and we proclaimed and declared those promises for our life.
The very next day, Jim got two job offers.
Hello.
I had been working for 2 years on my own, struggling to get somebody to return a phone call to me. So God is bigger than I ever gave him credit for. He can do things that are impossible. He's not affected by the economy. He's not affected by anything. He's God.
I love what Jim and Janet did when they stopped cursing themselves and they asked God, please forgive us for that. God is the God of second chances. He's the God of third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh chances. He's the God of 70 times seven chances. That when you turn to him and you ask him for help, he will give it to you. And he can turn any curse into a blessing if you just let him. Here's the promise. It's from Deuteronomy chapter 23. The Lord your God turned the curse into a blessing for you because the Lord your God loves you. Now, some of you, you're doing the same thing that Jim was doing. You're talking bad about the economy. You're talking bad about your situation. And instead of looking to the future and to what God has for you, and even looking to what God has for you today, you want to stay trapped in the past, and you want to start thinking, woe is you, it's all doom and gloom. Look to him. He's the author and the finisher of your faith. Look to his promises and do what Jim and Janet did. Pronounce the blessing of yourself. Read the promises. Believe the promises. Proclaim the promises and see if it will happen to you. Now, I've got some wonderful news. Some CBN partners, just like Jim and Janet, say, we love giving. We love living a life of generosity. We love the promises that God has for those that give. And so they want to challenge you, and they'll match your gifts up dollar for dollar up to $50,000 for the next 30 minutes. Let's pray. Lord, we just ask for blessing over this. And Lord, we proclaim the promises, the great and precious promises that you've made, that they're all yes and amen for those who are in Christ Jesus. And so we proclaim your promise over your children, and we ask for blessing for them. Do it, Lord, for we ask it all in Jesus' name, amen. You heard it, a $50,000 challenge. What that means is existing CBN partners say, we want to challenge others to give. And so for the next 30 minutes and 50 seconds, they'll match you dollar for dollar up to $50,000. Now, what are we asking you to do? We're asking you to join the 700 Club, to say, yes, in 2013, I want to start a life of giving. I want to be generous. I want to help the poor. I want to help preach the gospel around the world. When you join the 700 Club, a portion of every gift goes into the work of CBN International to do just that, where we're broadcasting in over 130 countries, over 40 languages, and we're doing it in your name when you join with us. Another portion goes into the work of Operation Blessing. And that's an organization that loves to help people. When disasters strike, they want to strike back. We're sending disaster teams around the world. We're doing it in your name when you join with us. So if that's you, go to the phone and call us, 1-800-759-0700. How much is it to join the 700 Club? Well, it's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day. Some of you say, well, I can join at a higher level. We've got 700 Club Gold for you, $40 a month. And then there's a 1,000 Club, and that's $1,000 a year, and that breaks out to $84 a month. At whatever level God is speaking to you to give, now's the time to do it. Join with us, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, we've got something special for you. When you join the 700 Club, we're going to send you our latest DVD. It's called Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2. In this, you're going to meet 9 people who died, visited heaven or hell, and then came back to tell their stories. Here's a sneak preview.
It's a question each one of us must face. It's the most important decision you'll ever make. Where will you spend eternity?
In Gordon Robertson's newest DVD, Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll meet real people who have died and experienced heaven or hell. See their personal eyewitness accounts of what happens when we die.
There's more love than you can imagine.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
In Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll discover a powerful tool to share the gospel with those you love, what the Bible says about eternal life, and how you can know for certain that heaven is your destiny.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You can have the assurance that when you die and are absent from your body, you'll be present with Jesus for all eternity.
You want to get a hold of these amazing accounts of death experiences, people who experienced heaven or hell and then came back to tell about it. It's said that one man's experience trumps another man's opinion. So we want you to hear about the experiences of 9 people. Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2. It's yours when you join the 700 Club. Our number's toll free. It's 1-800-759-0700. Call right now. You can also log on to CBN.com and join with us that way. Gordon?
Well, Hurricane Sandy was one of the most expensive natural disasters in American history. Many storm survivors don't even have the money to clean up what's left of their homes. And that's why Operation Blessing is in New York and New Jersey, bringing hope and help to those who need it.
It's been a devastating winter for the residents of Breezy Point, New York. Although Hurricane Sandy hit in late October, many people here are still without water, electricity, and basic necessities.
Pretty much lost mostly everything. The electric was underwater, all my appliances and furniture and beds, and most of the clothing was damaged.
But the people in Breezy Point haven't had to face this disaster alone. Since the first critical hours following the storm, Operation Blessing has been here, helping Breezy Point storm victims recover.
Operation Blessing had a huge trailer in our community here, and they offered to come over and help remove the debris and the couches and the furniture and everything, because I wouldn't have been able to do any of it, you know, without the assistance.
Operation Blessing Director of Disaster Relief, Jody Geddes, says they've worked on over 400 homes.
A lot of that was the gutting out and the cleaning of homes, but now we're rebuilding. We'll be taking one house at a time, two houses at a time, three houses at a time. But as we progress on each project, on each home, other people see the progress and it gives them encouragement, it gives them strength knowing that they can rebuild their lives too.
As the people of Breezy Point rebuild their lives, they will never forget those that came in their time of need.
Operation Blessing has been just another way of God showing me that it'll be okay, that we'll get through it, that, you know, what will be, and we'll be able to come back and have everything like we had it before.
That's what we want to do, and we're doing it in your name. We want to give people a hope and a future. When disasters strike, we want to strike back with love, compassion, and very tangible help in their time of need. If you want to be a part of that, join with us. Join the 700 Club. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. A portion of every gift goes into the work of Operation Blessing to help people around the world. And if you want to be a part of it, all you have to do is join the 700 Club. Now, when you call and join, ask for Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. The bank does all the work. There's no checks to write, nothing to mail in. We save so much on the processing we can send as our gift to you. Power for Life, monthly teaching CDs. So if you'd like those, ask for Pledge Express when you call or just log on to CBN.com. When you join via the internet and give monthly, you automatically sign up for Pledge Express. Terry?
Well, when you join the 700 Club, you're helping people here in the United States, like you just saw, but you're also helping people all over the world, like this family in China. Shortly after their baby's birth, they were told to start preparing for his death.
The Zhongs were thrilled when their son Haoxun was born, until they heard that he had a hole in his heart.
When the doctor told me Haoxun had heart disease, my world fell apart.
It was our worst nightmare.
I was so worried about my brother. Every time he cried, it made me cry too.
And Haoxun cried all the time.
He could not breathe, and he would choke on his tears. I was so scared that he would choke to death in his sleep. The hole in Haoshun's heart grew bigger, and since his poor parents could not afford surgery, they knew they would soon lose their son. Then, just as they were about to give up hope, they heard about CBN's mission to help needy children like theirs.
When CBN said they would help us with surgery, I almost shouted with joy.
This meant my son would live. A doctor repaired the hole in Haoshun's heart and repositioned his artery. Today, you'd never know how close this precious little boy once came to losing his life.
My son is healthy and happy now. I never thought that such a wonderful thing would happen to my family.
Thank you for your loving heart for my son. Your help healed my broken heart and made me whole and strong again.
I love my little brother. Thank you so much for saving his life.
What if that was your little boy? What if you couldn't do what needed to be done to save his life? You knew there was something that could be done, but you just couldn't afford it. 700 Club members are making that kind of a difference in the lives of people all around the world every day of the week. That's why we're asking you to join with us. Make a difference. You can be a part of this kind of a solution. Our number is toll-free. It's on your screen right now. We've got a $50,000 challenge before us. That means when you call and join the 700 Club, every dollar you pledge will be matched dollar for dollar. Where do you get that kind of an increase today? Let's go over to Christy. Christy?
Thank you so much, Terry. Well, if you could get a glimpse of life after death, how would that change the way you live now? Well, we talked to a few people who faced that very question after they died and found themselves in hell. Then they got a second chance at life. Take a look.
I could hear these moans and these cries.
And I could feel my body leaving.
It was pitch black dark.
That was the moment where I understood what death was.
Can I tell you that this DVD is one of those DVDs that will change your life and impact your life for a lifetime? I tell you what, I got saved when I was 5 years old because when our parents took us to a church and they showed us a movie about hell, and I came home and said, Mommy, I want to make sure I don't go there. And she said, well, if you accept Jesus as your Lord and Savior, into your heart, confess with your mouth, you won't. And from that point to this day, praise God, I know I'm going to go to heaven. Do you know that if you were to die today, where you would go? Well, I tell you what, you might be shaking your head and say, yes, Christy, I do know, but maybe I've got kids or children or spouses who don't know. This is the greatest witnessing tool. I tell you what, other than the Bible, you give this to them, and I tell you what, they will make a decision that will change their, not just life, but their eternity. So call in right now, join with us. We're in the middle of a challenge. What we're asking you to do is partner with us, and when you do partner with us, we're going to give you this $50,000 challenge, which means that every dollar that you give is doubled. Now, this is what's so cool, too. You know how I was just talking about the witnessing element of this? Now, you know how we've got, we all do, have a list of people that we pray for, and it might be 5 people, 10 people, what have you. Well, if you call in right now and you say we want to give 700 Club Gold, $40 a month, we're going to give you 3. For 5, we'll give you 5 if you join in at 1,000 Club, $84 a month. But the key is this, whatever you do, do something. Call in right now. We need you. If there's a little tug in your heart, don't let that moment pass by. We need you to pick up the phones right now. Call 1-800-759-0700 or log on to CBN.com. Gordon?
Well, it's part of the American dream. Be your own boss. Gary Parks got the chance to do just that when he developed a business idea simply by driving down the street.
Gary Parks is a hard worker, but he never could quite make ends meet. He worked at several part-time jobs, including working at a gas station and building welders. Even with the long hours he worked, he struggled to pay the bills. Sharon remembers when they had to buy food past its expiration date for their family at the discount grocery store.
My son would get out his cereal and he'd get ready to put it in, and there would be some bugs in there crawling around, and he would freak out.
We had an electric bill of $25, and we're trying to figure out where we could get the money for that.
Sharon started cleaning houses on the side to bring in some extra income.
You'd do whatever you had to do to pay your bills, so you worked.
Sharon also began to pray. She asked God to fix their finances. One day, she turned on the 700 Club.
And he started teaching about the law of reciprocity. And it really opened my eyes about tithing and giving and reaping and sowing and how God wants to bless us.
She joined the 700 Club from her small income cleaning houses. 3 months later, she got a contract making $8,000 a month cleaning commercial businesses. And Gary got a full-time job with benefits with the Florida Department of Forestry. He started watching the 700 Club with his wife and tithing from his paychecks too.
I just thought I would give this a try and see what it would do for me.
That's when Gary says God gave him the idea for his new company, cleaning up construction sites.
I seen a brand new house being built and construction debris was all over the yard. And the Lord said, you need to go and make a containment area and you need to haul that away. I started hauling January the 1st and January the 30th. In 30 days, I made more money than I did working all year long with the state of Florida Forestry Service.
Gary went from making $30,000 a year to six figures in just 12 months. There was such a demand for their work that Sharon quit her cleaning business and went to work for the hauling company.
It meant the more we make, the more we could give. And I was so excited for what he was doing in our lives.
Gary sold his business just 2 months before the recession hit the housing industry.
Started out with five dumpsters. When I sold the business, I had 18 trucks and 300 dumpsters. It wasn't me, the Lord was the one that told me to sell the business, and it was in his timing.
The Parks also taught their sons about giving, and today Kelly is a partner with his dad in a new demolition business.
Our profits have tripled, and our business is going up, and every year it seems we have more and more work, and we've never stopped. All it took was that one chance of giving, and look where we're at now.
What he's done for me and my family, he can also do for any other family out there.
I guarantee you, God will bless you. Just step out and he will meet you right there, wherever you're at. If it's even a penny or a dollar, he will bless you.
Here's the promise. It's from Proverbs chapter 3. Keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. Listen to that. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Sharon and Gary learned that faithful giving was the answer. And in response, God started giving them tremendous ideas that led to an increase that's unbelievable, and then guided them at specific points of when to sell the business, what to do with the proceeds, how to increase even more, even in the middle of the recession. God will do that for you if you just say, I will be faithful in giving. If you want to do that, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. How much is that? Well, it's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day. And when you call, ask for Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. The bank does all the work. There's no checks to write. And you know your gift is going to come in every single month. Ask for Pledge Express when you call, 1-800-759-0700. Well, today, many Americans are just one paycheck away from losing everything. For years, Bill and Tina Wilson lived that way, and until an unusual gift helped them increase their income.
A couple of years ago, Bill Wilson was the county deputy, and Tina was a stay-at-home mom with their three boys. The couple was excited about their growing family, but discouraged about their tight budget.
We're living from paycheck to paycheck, pretty much. And you look at your budget, then you look at your expenses that you have going out versus your money coming in, and you kind of like, how is this going to happen?
Not knowing if we'll have the food for groceries, mortgage, it was hard.
In 2009, Tina started watching the 700 Club and heard about the principle of tithing.
Off and on, we were tithing. When we could afford to tithe, we would tithe. The Lord just kept working on us, you know, to keep tithing, whether it was easy or not. I was convinced from watching the testimonies and reading the Bible. It started as a prayer to convince Bill, to show him how the principle worked.
Eventually, Bill and Tina started watching the 700 Club together regularly and decided to give $20 a month to CBN on top of their tithe. Just months later, they received a gift that dramatically changed their income.
Tina actually was looking for our family a milk cow.
Tina began looking for a Jersey cow that could provide her family with fresh dairy.
And Jersey cows are just so cute, you know, with their little long eyelashes and their big brown eyes.
She went online and she found a website for Jersey Acres. Tina emailed this lady. The lady emailed Tina back and asked Tina, for some reason, said, "Are you a Christian?"
And I was like, "Well, that's a strange question to ask. And why do you ask?" And she says, "Because I've been praying about this cow. I feel like the Lord wants me to give you the cow." And I was crying because it was an answer to my prayer to show Bill that the principle of giving and tithing works.
After starting their farm with their one cow, Bobby Joe, Bill and Tina increased their CBN pledge to $40 a month. In a single year, their one milk cow turned into a growing business, JTB Jersey Farms. Today, they sell milk, butter, and cheese.
Because it was the Lord's idea and He made it come about, I thought it only appropriate to give Him the glory. So we put J in front of T and B. It was Jesus' idea, and then Tina and Bill.
We've seen our business grow from only having one cow. Now we have five cows and a bull.
The Lord knew we would enjoy the dairy farming. The prayer started as being financially independent, not owing anyone, and we know we're on that road. It amazes me how many prayers are answered just in one business.
You have to take a step of faith. I know for a fact that the Lord will prevail and He will always step up.
To anyone who isn't convinced, I would say to just trust Him. He is the God of the universe, and we're His children, and He wants to prosper us and not to harm us. As a personal testimony, it works.
Trust Him. That's all He requires. All He wants is for us to trust in Him. And here's the promise. It's from Psalm 37. Trust in the Lord and do good. Then you will live safely in the land and prosper. Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you your heart's desire. And Tina's had an unusual heart desire. I want a dairy cow. And they started giving, and God started blessing them. And through that one heart's desire, a whole new business came out that blessed them and blessed their family, blessed their finances. It can happen to you if you just trust in the Lord. So if you want to start giving, call us, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, "Yes, I want to join the 700 Club." It's only $20 a month, 65 cents a day, and you join with tens of thousands of people that want to make a difference today, that want to see the gospel preached around the world, that want to see people helped in time of disaster. All of it made possible because people like you care enough to give. If that's you, give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, camping out can be fun in the summertime, but recently I met a family who lived in a tent all year long, even in the winter, through rain and snow and temperatures that reached 20 below zero.
I'm here in Porishkovo, Ukraine, in a gypsy camp. There are 13 people living inside this tent. This is Ruslan. He's one of them. He's 7 years old. There's a two-month-old baby in here. Ruslan is wet to the core because it's a cold, rainy day here. And this little family is doing their best to make a living. You can see the dad is making baskets out of pieces of twig that he's gathered from the woods. The mom right now is out gathering mushrooms so that she can bring some food home for her children. Our goal is to build a home for them that will take them out of the cold, out of the rain, and allow them to make it through the winter and maybe even have a good life here in Porishkovo.
Working with our CBN staff in Ukraine, Orphans Promise was quickly able to put together a plan to build a shelter for this family. The most efficient and timely solution was a house made of metal with a strong wood floor and a thick layer of insulation. An airtight window and door, along with a new wood-burning stove, makes this one of the best homes in this gypsy community. And some basic furnishings and warm blankets will keep this family comfortable all winter. During my visit, we were alarmed at the condition of the two-month-old baby boy who had a terrible cough and fever. His mother was so malnourished that nursing him just wasn't enough.
That day, we gave her formula and medicine for little Petro. Now he's no longer sick, has put on weight, and looks much healthier. In fact, everyone looks healthier and happier. In addition to the father's basket making, we have plans to help them with a garden or other livelihood that will bring in enough money to sustain this family.
I thank God for the help you have given us. I couldn't even dream that someone would give us such a house. Thank you.
These are hardworking people who move around to different countries in the area as crops need to be picked. They're migrant workers, and they work very, very hard, but sometimes it's just not enough. You allowed us to come right into the middle of that need and to solve a huge need, not just for those parents, but for their children as winter came upon them. You can know right now today, 700 Club members, because of you, they are in a warm home, and they're able to eat and provide for their family, and we say thank you for that. This kind of help is what we're extending to people in need around the world, and that's why we're asking you today to go to your phone and be a part of that. Join with thousands of us who are out to make a difference. You really can. A general 700 Club membership is $20 a month. That's 65 cents a day. When you give right now in the middle of the challenge that we're in, every dollar you give will be matched dollar for dollar up to $50,000. But let me let you see all of the club levels you can join, because maybe you already are a 700 Club member. Would you go up to 700 Club Gold today? That's a gift of $40 a month. Or join us as a 1,000 Club member. That's $84 a month, $1,000 a year. Our 2,500 Club members join us at $2,500 a year. That's $209 a month. Then we have a founders level, $5,000 a year. That translates to $417 a month. We even have a group we call the Chairman's Circle. These are folks who can give $10,000 or more a year. Ask God what he'd have you do to make this kind of incredible, life-changing difference for people who simply need a helping hand. Call now, 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
All right, I've got some great news. CBN donors are saying $50,000 on a challenge isn't enough. They want to add $75,000 to it, take it to $125,000.
Yes. Right.
And we get to the end of the hour. Let's pray. Lord, we ask for blessing over this, and we ask for windows in heaven to be open over the donors who made it possible to issue this challenge. And for those watching, making decisions right now, we just ask that you would bless them and encourage them. Do it all, Lord, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. And amen. $125,000 on a challenge, 20 minutes to go. We need to hear from you, so call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Well, in Honduras, many people can't afford the most basic medical care. So Operation Blessing set up clinics with free doctors and medicine. And for the baby in one village, that meant the difference between life and death.
When three-month-old Brian woke up with a cough, his mother wasn't too worried and prepared some home remedies. Hours later, Brian got worse.
He began to cough and had a fever. Then it became hard for him to breathe. I thought we were losing him, that he was going to die.
I panicked. I thought, we are poor. We don't have money for a doctor or a clinic.
That's when they remembered a clinic in another town that had medicine donated from an organization in America. But it was already late, and the clinic was closed. The next morning, Maricruz raced to the clinic.
When I got there, I saw all these people. But I was so desperate, I just ran into one of the doctor's office and said, help me, my son is dying.
The doctor quickly checked Brian and told his mother that he had pneumonia. But as soon as Brian received his first breathing treatment with medicine provided by Operation Blessing, he started to perk up. The doctor then gave Brian's mom strong antibiotics that had also been given to the clinic by Operation Blessing. Those antibiotics saved Brian's life.
The doctor told me what to do, and I gave him all of the medicine.
Within a few days, Brian was feeling much better. And when his mom took him back to the clinic 10 days later, the doctor gave Brian a clean bill of health.
I don't know how to thank you saving my son's life with that wonderful medicine. May God bless Operation Blessing.
And may God bless you. If you're a member of the 700 Club, you're part of that. You're part of helping that little baby. And if you're not a member, join with us. Be part of it. Be part of helping people around the world. If you want to see people given free medical care, if you want to see fresh drinking water going into villages around the world, if you want to see disaster relief teams be able to be deployed after storms, after earthquakes, after tsunamis, if you want to be a part of preaching the gospel around the world, well, all you have to do is join the 700 Club, and you join in with everything we're doing around the world. If that's you, if that's what you want to do, call us now, 1-800-759-0700. We're in the middle of a $125,000 challenge. What that means is existing 700 Club members say, we like a life of generosity, and we want to challenge others to give. And so they'll match your giving for the next 17 minutes and 15 seconds. They'll match you dollar for dollar up to $125,000. So join with us. Be part of it. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
Thanks, Gordon. Well, earlier we heard from someone who went to hell. Now we want to show you someone who went to heaven and came back to tell their amazing story. Take a look.
The first thing that comes to me is he's bright, just like John says, he's brighter than the noonday sun. And the next phrase I say, I wish people could grab it, and it's this one. And we can look at him. Everything is right. There's nothing wrong here. And I said, it's past peace. Peace past understanding. That's what's going on there. You're really experiencing the love he has for you.
So today on my way to work, the car in front of me, the vanity plate says, happy forever. You know, that's what God has for us in heaven. The Bible says in this life we'll have trouble, but heaven, it says, is a place of no more tears, no more sadness. That's what God has for us, but the choice is ours in this life. How do we make that choice? We either choose Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, or we spend eternity in hell, a place where we wouldn't want to send our worst enemy. Well, if you'd like to hear more stories of the man, just like the man who went to heaven and others who have come back from with warnings from hell, we want you to have Life Beyond the Grave, part two. This is our gift to you when you call right now and join the 700 Club. How much is it? 65 cents a day, $20 a month to do so much incredible stuff around the world. Now, if you're already a 700 Club member, we want to say thank you so much. We can't do it without you, and we are so grateful. But I want to challenge you. Why not take it up to the next level? How about the gold level? Just $40 a month. We're going to send you three Life Beyond the Graves, one for you, two to give away. And hey, what about the 1,000 Club level? $84 a month. A lot of us can do that. We're going to send you five so you can share this with so many people that you've been praying for, people that you don't want to go to hell. We want you to have this Life Beyond the Grave Part 2. It's our gift to you when you call right now. We're in the middle of a $125,000 challenge with just 15 minutes left on the clock. So if you go to your phones right now, every dollar that you pledge will be matched dollar for dollar. Gordon?
While many Americans are struggling to find work, Marlene Carter had three jobs. But at the end of every month, she still didn't have enough money to pay her bills.
If something was going to shut off, that's what I'd have to pay. If something else wasn't going to shut off, I wouldn't pay it, but the next month it was going to shut off. So that's the kind of life I was living.
Marlene Carter's life was a financial catastrophe. She worked three jobs and still couldn't pay all the bills.
It was a juggling act.
Marlene began praying for a solution. She also started watching the 700 Club.
A lot of times after my third job, I would have to go grocery shopping late at night. And so here I'd be putting away my groceries and I'd have the television on in the kitchen and CBN was on, and I just was fascinated.
One of those lessons was giving away 10% of your income.
I remember thinking, oh my, I work three jobs and I'm still juggling my bills. I don't see how I'd be able to come up with money just to send in for a donation, you know, and it just seemed real foreign to me. But then I think that the Lord was convicting me to try it.
Marlene gave to several ministries, including to CBN, and somehow was able to make her money stretch.
A lot of times on paper it didn't make sense, and I'd heard people say that, and I can testify that that is the truth. Sometimes it's like, this doesn't add up, but it's amazing how that happens.
Then Marlene increased her giving, and a few months later landed a new job making more than all three of her previous jobs combined.
I was really grateful. I was tremendously relieved.
And when Marlene increased her giving again, she got a promotion.
He said, test me on this, and that I would open the windows of heaven and pour out blessings more than you can contain, and it is the truth.
It is the truth. It seems strange, and it seems strange to Marlene. You know, how do you start getting more just because you start giving? Well, here we call it the law of reciprocity, and it's one of the secrets to the kingdom of God. And you find it in Luke, where it's give and it will be given unto you. So often we want to say, okay, let's get enough money and then I can start giving from the excess I have. But God says, no, do it my way. Give and it will be given unto you. That's what Marlene discovered. It's one of the great secrets of the kingdom of God. And when you put that principle into practice, what God has done for others, He will do for you. So if you want to start a life of generosity, a life of giving, call us, 1-800-759-0700. What are we asking you to do? We're asking you to join the 700 Club. It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day, and you join with tens of thousands of people that want to see the gospel go around the world, that want to see people help through Operation Blessing, that want to see fresh water wells dug around the world. If that's you, be a part of everything we're doing by joining the 700 Club. When you call, ask for Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. The bank does all the work. There's no checks to write, nothing to mail in. We save so much on the processing. We can send Power for Life monthly teaching CDs back to you as our gift to you when you join Pledge Express. Do it now. Call us, 1-800-759-0700, or log on to CBN.com. When you give monthly on the giving page, you automatically sign up for Pledge Express. Terry?
Well, I don't know about dinner time at your house, but about 5 or 6 o'clock at my house, people start saying, Mom, what's for dinner? Imagine having to face your children at dinner time and tell them that you don't have anything to feed them. Angel and Myrna faced that situation almost every day after a hurricane destroyed their family business. Take a look.
9-year-old Wendy took tiny bites, trying to make the small cracker last. It would be her only meal that day.
We didn't have money to buy food, and we only ate crackers. My stomach ached a lot.
But Wendy's mother was already losing hope. Myrna still cries when she thinks about those terrible days.
I knew my children were hungry. They always asked for more, but I didn't have anything to give them.
A hurricane had swept through their town in Mexico, destroying their home and their family's small ice cream cart. Their only way to make a living.
I searched the flood waters for my cart, but I couldn't find it. I only found a few pieces in the river.
With the few containers they found, they made the homemade ice cream, but without the cart to keep it cold, it was hard to sell. So Angel bought a used cart that had been badly damaged in the storm.
I had no money to fix it, and we didn't have enough to eat.
Operation Blessing decided to help. First, we gave Angel new parts, paint, and tools he needed to fix up that damaged cart. Soon, the broken-down cart looked brand new. Then, we bought Angel a large amount of sugar, cream, and other commodities lost in the flood.
I've never imagined how much help I was going to receive from Operation Blessing. My profits had doubled what I made before the hurricane. Now I can feed my family.
I give thanks to Operation Blessing for everything they gave to us. It is hard to find words to express my thanks to you. Thank you.
This is just one of thousands of families whose lives have been touched by your generosity, 700 Club members. We want you to know that. And to those of you who haven't yet made the commitment to join, come on with us. We really can make a difference. It's so satisfying to know you can touch someone's life like that. How do you do it? You go to your phone and you call that toll-free number, 1-800-759-0700, and you say, I want to join the 700 Club. And then we'd like to ask you to say, and I'd like to do it using Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. It means your bank does all the work, but it saves us processing costs so that we can put even more of your money directly into the lives of people like Angel and his family. And our way of saying thank you for using Pledge Express is to send you Power for Life teachings. We get these here at CBN as a family. We'd like to share them with you and your family. So call right now, 1-800-759-0700. Say, I want to join the 700 Club, and I'd like to do it using Pledge Express, and you can also join by logging onto CBN.com. Gordon?
Well, tonight, 1 in 7 American families will go to bed hungry. And that's why Operation Blessing is working all over America to help struggling families put food on the table.
Chris Price supports his wife and two children by working as an auto technician.
My job to me is very important. I thank God every day that I have a job.
But a recent cut in his hours has made it hard just to put food on the table. So the family is finding creative ways to stretch their budget. Chris walks 2 miles each way to and from work to save on gas. And they get food from Operation Blessing partner, Joseph Storehouse.
If I didn't have the food, I probably would have missed water or electric this month just so I can buy the food for my family.
Bob Evans is the founder of Joseph Storehouse. He says helping families is a team effort.
I don't know what we'd do without Operation Blessing. They've been such a blessing to us to bring in a variety of food. We never know what we're going to get, kind of like Christmas every once a month.
It put food in our kitchen for us, and my wife and my kids and me are very, very grateful for that. I'm glad to know that there's other people out there trying to help the people that are trying to do the best for their family.
We don't want to give handouts. We want to give a hand up to help people who are in need. And in America today, it's incredible how many people are really struggling. When you start thinking that 1 in 7 American families have got people that are going to bed hungry, we want to help them, and we're doing it in a big way. 3 million Americans every single month receive food from Operation Blessing. We've got our trucks are traveling literally every day where we are distributing donated food, purchased food to food banks all across the nation, and you can be a part of it when you join the 700 Club. If that's you, do it right now. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Just say, yes, I want to be a part of helping people. I want to be a part of CBN. I want to be a part of the 700 Club. I want to be a part of Operation Blessing. I want to be a part of CBN International. You're part of all of it when you join the 700 Club. So do it now. Call us now, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go over to Christy at the phones. Christy?
Thank you, Gordon. Well, a couple years ago, we produced a DVD called Life Beyond the Grave. Well, check this out. We just released part 2, and people are already talking about it. Take a look.
I didn't really think much about the afterlife before I became a Christian, but after I saw the DVD, it really made me think about what's going to come and how it's going to be and what it's going to be like. I think it's good for people who are searching, whether they're searching from the standpoint of any type of religion. It's just really an eye-opening experience. I really enjoyed the fact that it really talks about firsthand accounts. You can tell in the sincerity of what they're talking about and their emotions and their feelings. This was a real situation that they experienced and they remember. I even ponder it even today, just thinking about it after watching the DVD. If you're curious about the afterlife, Life Beyond the Grave is a great source, and I believe it will provide answers to your questions. Whether you believe in heaven or hell, you will one way or the other by watching the DVD.
This DVD isn't just life-changing, it is provoking. I mean, it's one of those DVDs that you cannot help but look at and really fall on your knees before the Lord and just, you know, really be like, Lord, are you real? Which he's real. So this is our gift to you when you become a 700 Club partner. The first one that we did about a year or so ago, it was so popular that we had to put this second one out there, and people absolutely love it. And it's our gift to you when you join in for 65 cents a day, $20 a month. It's all it takes. And we're doing something really cool because, as I said before, this really is one of those life-altering, life-changing DVDs. What we're doing is we're offering you more than one. How can you get more than one? Well, we'll give you three if you take it up a notch from 700 Club to 700 Club Gold by giving $40 a month, or for 1,000 Club member, we'll give you 5. That way you could keep one for yourself, give the 4 away. And you might say, well, Christy, why do I need 4 or 5 of the same DVDs? Come on, we all have that list of people that we've been praying for, our kids, our spouses, grandkids, our neighbors. What a great witnessing tool just to share how much God loves us and to tell people that, you know what, we get so concerned with life now, but what about life for eternity? This is it, and it needs to be in your hands. So call in right now. We're in the middle of a challenge. We've got 3 minutes left on this challenge, $125,000, which means that when you call, that dollar is doubled. So I'm going to head over to Terry. Terry?
Thanks, Christy. In many third world countries, a little help goes a long way, and it doesn't take much to support an entire family. For one man in India,
all it took was a fishing net and a bicycle.
When floods hit the east coast of India, Dalai's fishing nets washed away, leaving him with no way to make a living or feed his family.
It was horrible to see our entire village submerged underwater. We lost everything we owned. My family was starving.
CBN responded quickly to the disaster with relief supplies, food, and sleeping mats.
When we lost everything, you were the only ones that helped us. You gave us what we needed to survive.
What we gave him next really put a smile on his daughter's face.
I was so happy when you gave my father a brand new fishing net, a bicycle to bring his fish to the market, and an icebox to keep the fish fresh.
Thank you so much for helping us. You gave me exactly what I needed to support my family. You have restored my life.
You gotta love it. When we lost everything, you were the only ones who came to help. That's what you do around the world. Join with us right now, especially in the midst of this challenge, because every dollar you pledge gets matched dollar for dollar. Call right now, 1-800-759-0700, or log on to CBN.com. Gordon?
Well, not long ago in Nigeria, we met a four-year-old girl named Rimian. She had been abandoned by her parents, and when we found her, she was crying, hungry, and wandering the streets of her village alone.
Four-year-old Rimbian enjoys school, but just a few months ago, things were very different. Rimbian was born with a cleft lip and abandoned by her parents. An Operation Blessing social worker found the little girl walking through the village alone.
I met Rimbian one early morning, walking around the streets, crying, looking very dirty and looking hungry. Children were scared of her because of the cleft palate she had. Then I took her to our office.
Rimbian's grandfather found out from Operation Blessing that she needed a place to stay, so he took her into his home.
I love her, so I want her future to prosper.
Operation Blessing paid for the surgery to repair Rimbian's cleft lip, then enrolled her at a special boarding school where she received speech therapy. Thanks to the gifts of CBN partners, Rimbian is attending a school where she has plenty of friends and a loving grandfather nearby.
We are very grateful. And God bless you, CBN. Thank you very much.
And thank you. If you're a member of the 700 Club, you're part of blessing that little, wonderful little girl to give her a hope and a future, to give her a smile. If you're not a member, join with us. Join in everything we're doing around the world. 1-800-759-0700. We're counting down to victory. Just 5, 4, 3, 2, 1 seconds left on this wonderful $125,000 challenge. It's been a great morning. We had this tremendous challenge, and against it, you gave $172,000. Well, we leave you today with these words from Proverbs. He who gives to the poor will lack nothing. Keep that in mind. When you give to the poor, God wants to bless you. For Terry, for Christy, for Wendy, for me, all of us, God bless you. We'll see you again.
Hi, this is Pat Robertson. This is an important time in the history of America. It's an important time in the history of CBN. And what you do is so very important now. But we've got to get the gospel out here in America. We've got to help the poor and the needy, feed those who are hungry, clothe those who are naked, bring medical attention to those who are suffering, and more than anything, bring hope to those who are without hope throughout the world. So your 700 Club membership makes a huge difference. And I ask you to go to your phone and call. If you haven't already called in, we appreciate what you've done so much. So don't slack. We don't want our hands to be empty. We want to say, Lord, here are those who have come to you because of my labors. Telephones are available, toll-free line, and we just thank God for each one of you. So don't hesitate to call and do it now.
I think the DVD Life Beyond the Grave will inspire anybody. It inspired me, it inspired my 13-year-old daughter, and I think that it would help anybody who doubts the reality of heaven and hell. This is a great opportunity for you to see inside a personal experience. I was reminded when I was watching the DVD that forgiveness is just a prayer away and that there's no sin that cannot be forgiven. God loves us more than we can ever know.
Welcome to the 700 Club. Another brutal cold wave is hitting much of the country, and it's bringing temperatures well below zero.
This freezing snow and cold is more than just uncomfortable. It's also dangerous. Charlene Israel has the story.
I don't even want to go out of the house.
Really cold.
It's like needles sticking in your face.
More than 100 million people are waking up in an icebox this morning. Wind chill advisories have been posted in 15 states from the Midwest to the East Coast. On Tuesday, the wind chill in Maine brought temperatures to 50 below. Around the Great Lakes, minus 40. And in North Carolina, 10 below. The extreme cold is already being blamed for at least four deaths. Blinding snow caused a 150-car pileup in Ohio. And people working outside, like construction workers, are at risk of hypothermia or frostbite.
Pretty quickly, you can start to experience symptoms of frostbite within 5 to 10 minutes of being outside.
Even inside, the cold temperatures can make life uncomfortable.
All the cold air from outside came in, got cold enough overnight with the low temperatures, and it simply froze the water service in the house.
You can't do anything. I mean, pretty much. You go to wash your hands, you can't even do that. Yeah, no coffee, no toilet, can't flush the toilet.
Meteorologists say the weather is likely to get even worse, with even colder conditions coming in by the end of the week.
This air mass that has set in from the plains all the way toward the mid-Atlantic and the Northeast is some of the coldest air that we've seen in at least a couple of years.
High temperatures across the Midwest and Northeast are expected to remain below freezing until at least the weekend. Charlene Israel, CBN News.
Well, it may be cold in much of the country, but Secretary of State Hillary Clinton could be taking some heat on Capitol Hill today. Lee Webb has that story from the CBN newsroom. Lee?
That's right, Gordon. Mrs. Clinton facing tough questions today about Libya. She's finally testifying about the September attack on the U.S. consulate in Benghazi. Four Americans, including Ambassador Chris Stevens, died in the attack. Clinton postponed her testimony last month due to a concussion and a blood clot near her brain. Republicans claim the Obama administration ignored signs of deteriorating security in Libya and refused requests for more security. They also say the administration portrayed an act of terrorism as just protest over an anti-Muslim film. Well, Israelis voted for a change in their government, but it wasn't the change most expected. Chris Mitchell reports on the surprising results of an election that saw the highest turnout in more than a decade.
As expected, Benjamin Netanyahu's combined Likud-Betanu party received the most seats. But center-left parties received more seats than anticipated. The results put Israel's center-right and center-left parties split down the middle at 60 seats apiece.
The big news of the evening was the emergence of Yair Lapid and his center-left party. It will have a major impact on how Bibi Netanyahu will be able to form the next coalition government.
But that's the big news. It's very much a kind of centrist picture. That's what's coming out here. That's what the Israeli electorate is looking like.
The results mean Netanyahu will likely be the next prime minister and form the next government. He goes into negotiations weaker than expected, but some believe Lapid can help him. Others are uncertain about what the next Israeli government will look like and how long it will last. With a divided electorate, some anticipate Israelis might be going to the polls again in the not-too-distant future. Chris Mitchell, CBN News, Tel Aviv.
Gordon, what are your predictions for Israel's future as a result of this election?
Well, I've read the Bible, Lee, and Israel's got a great future ahead of it, but they need to recognize that God's in charge and God is the source of all of their strength. When you look back over their history, there have been plenty of bleak times before. Way back in 1948, that first war where the Arabs tried to drive them into the sea, no one would sell them weapons. Not even the United States would do that. It was interesting that Czechoslovakia was the only place, the only nation that would sell Israel modern weapons, and a heroic few, with the aid of God, were able to struggle through and win 67, the same thing. All the nations around them attacked them, and they won a tremendous victory. And then the Yom Kippur War, where they're caught completely off guard, God intervened. And we just need to remember, God has a special plan for Israel, and He will fulfill His word over her. We'll be back with more of the 700 Club right after this.
It was the most angelic, the most
peaceful, safe, loving place.
I wasn't afraid.
There was not a feeling of time.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You just can't even imagine.
It's part of the American dream. Be your own boss. Well, Gary Parks got the chance to do just that when he developed a business idea simply by driving down the street.
Gary Parks is a hard worker, but he never could quite make ends meet. He worked at several part-time jobs, including working at a gas station and building welders. Even with the long hours he worked, he struggled to pay the bills. Sharon remembers when they had to buy food past its expiration date for their family at the discount grocery store.
My son would get out his cereal and he'd get ready to put it in, and there would be some bugs in there crawling around, and he would freak out.
We had an electric bill of $25, and we're trying to figure out where we could get the money for that.
Sharon started cleaning houses on the side to bring in some extra income.
You'd do whatever you had to do to pay your bills, so you worked.
Sharon also began to pray. She asked God to fix their finances. One day, she turned on the 700 Club.
And he started teaching about the law of reciprocity. And it really opened my eyes about tithing and giving and reaping and sowing and how God wants to bless us.
She joined the 700 Club from her small income cleaning houses. 3 months later, she got a contract making $8,000 a month cleaning commercial businesses. And Gary got a full-time job with benefits with the Florida Department of Forestry. He started watching the 700 Club with his wife and tithing from his paychecks too.
I just thought I would give this a try and see what it would do for me.
That's when Gary says God gave him the idea for his new company, cleaning up construction sites.
I seen a brand new house being built and construction debris was all over the yard. And the Lord said, you need to go and make a containment area and you need to haul that away. I started hauling January the 1st and January the 30th. In 30 days, I made more money than I did working all year long with the state of Florida Forestry Service.
Gary went from making $30,000 a year to six figures in just 12 months. There was such a demand for their work that Sharon quit her cleaning business and went to work for the hauling company.
It meant the more we make, the more we could give. And I was so excited for what he was doing in our lives.
Gary sold his business just 2 months before the recession hit the housing industry.
Started out with five dumpsters. And when I sold the business, I had 18 trucks and 300 dumpsters. It wasn't me, the Lord was the one that told me to sell the business, and it was in His timing.
The Parks also taught their sons about giving, and today Kelly is a partner with his dad in a new demolition business.
Our profits have tripled, and our business is going up, and every year it seems we have more and more work. And we've never stopped. All it took was that one chance of giving, and look where we're at now.
What he's done for me and my family, he can also do for any other family out there.
I guarantee you, God will bless you. Just step out, and He will meet you right there, wherever you're at. If it's even a penny or a dollar, He will bless you.
I love this story because Gary and Sharon did that. They took the step out, and with their finances, and also took the risk to start businesses. You know, here's Sharon, and she's, you know, feeding her children dated food. It's got insects in it. And instead of saying, complaining, she says, what do I need to do? What do I need to do? And so she started to say, okay, I'm going to live my life God's way, and I'm going to give. And then God gave her an idea for a business that very quickly started generating $8,000 a month. And so her husband sees that. Gary sees that, and he says, well, if she can do it, I can do it. And so he joins in, God gives him an idea for a business that nets him more money in a month than he made in his previous job in a whole year, and then guides him along the way so that he gives him specific direction as to when to sell, what to do, and then how to reinvest that and start yet another business. They discovered the great things that can happen when you just obey and live God's way. Here it is from Proverbs chapter 3. Keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. Let love and faithfulness never leave you. And Gary and Sharon learn that if you're faithful in giving, God will reward you. He'll give you things. Well, today, many Americans are just one paycheck away from losing everything. For years, Bill and Tina Wilson lived that way, and until an unusual gift helped them increase their income.
A couple of years ago, Bill Wilson was the county deputy, and Tina was a stay-at-home mom with their three boys. The couple was excited about their growing family, but discouraged about their tight budget.
We're living from paycheck to paycheck, pretty much. And you look at your budget, then you look at your expenses that you have going out versus your money coming in, and you kind of like, how is this going to happen?
Not knowing if we'll have the food for groceries, mortgage, it was hard.
In 2009, Tina started watching the 700 Club and heard about the principle of tithing.
Off and on, we were tithing. When we could afford to tithe, we would tithe. The Lord just kept working on us, you know, to keep tithing, whether it was easy or not. I was convinced from watching the testimonies and reading the Bible. It started as a prayer to convince Bill, to show him how the principle worked.
Eventually, Bill and Tina started watching the 700 Club together regularly and decided to give $20 a month to CBN on top of their tithe. Just months later, they received a gift that dramatically changed their income.
Tina actually was looking for our family a milk cow.
Tina began looking for a Jersey cow that could provide her family with fresh dairy.
And Jersey cows are just so cute, you know, with their little long eyelashes and their big brown eyes.
She went online and she found a website for Jersey Acres. Tina emailed this lady. The lady emailed Tina back and asked Tina, for some reason, said, are you a Christian?
And I was like, well, that's a strange question to ask. And why do you ask? And she says, because I've been praying about this cow. I feel like the Lord wants me to give you the cow. And I was crying because it was an answer to my prayer to show Bill that the principle of giving and tithing works.
After starting their farm with their one cow, Bobby Joe, Bill and Tina increased their CBN pledge to $40 a month. In a single year, their one milk cow turned into a growing business, JTB Jersey Farms. Today, they sell milk, butter, and cheese.
Because it was the Lord's idea and He made it come about, I thought it only appropriate to give Him the glory. So we put J in front of T and B. It was Jesus' idea, and then Tina and Bill.
We've seen our business grow from only having one cow. Now we have five cows and a bull.
The Lord knew we would enjoy the dairy farming. The prayer started as being financially independent, not owing anyone, and we know we're on that road. It amazes me how many prayers are answered just in one business.
You have to take a step of faith. I know for a fact that the Lord will prevail and He will always step up.
To anyone who isn't convinced, I would say to just trust Him. He is the God of the universe, and we're His children, and He wants to prosper us and not to harm us. As a personal testimony, it works.
You can trust Him. And when you trust Him with your finances, you understand that it works. Here's the promise from Psalm 37. Trust in the Lord and do good. Then you will live safely in the land and prosper. Take delight in the Lord, and He will give you your heart's desires. And here's Tina. She's looking for a milk cow, and she says, I'm going to trust God for this. And out of the blue, she finds a Christian that's got one, and they say, God told me to give it to you. God wants to give you your heart's desire if you just trust Him. and trust him with your tithes and offerings. Now, if I can get a drum roll, I've got some great news. Some existing CBN partners, just like Bill and Tina, say, we love giving, and we love living the generous life where we give generously. And so they want to challenge you, and what they're saying is, if you give, they'll match you dollar for dollar up to $125,000. We've got 30 minutes on a clock, and let's pray. Lord, we ask for blessing. We ask for blessing for the partners of CBN, those who have given and given generously. And we just ask for windows in heaven to be open over their lives, that you would give them their heart's desire, that you would pour out so much that they cannot contain it. Let them rejoice in the blessing of the Lord. And for those watching right now, making decisions, I just ask that you would speak to them and encourage them. Bless them, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. $125,000 on a challenge, 30 minutes to go on a clock. What a challenge is existing CBN partners like giving so much, they want to challenge others to give. And so they'll match you dollar for dollar. Up to $125,000. So if you give $20, it's like giving $40. If you give $1,000, it's like giving $2,000. Your gift is automatically doubled. So what are we asking you to do? We're asking you to join the 700 Club. How much is that? Well, it's $20 a month, 65 cents a day. Some of you say, I can give more than that. I can give 700 Club Gold, which is $40 a month. 1,000 Club is $1,000 a year, and that breaks out to $84 a month. We've got 2,500 Club, which is $2,500 a year. Founders is $5,000 a year. And then Chairman Circle, $10,000 or more a year. At whatever level, God is speaking to you to give. Now's the time to do it because we've got this wonderful challenge before us. We don't want to lose any part of it. We want to go over the top on this. Give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, when you do give us a call and you join the 700 Club, we want to send you our latest DVD. It's called Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2. In this, you're going to meet 9 people who died, visited heaven or hell, and then came back to tell their stories. Here's a sneak preview.
It's a question each one of us must face. It's the most important decision you'll ever make. Where will you spend eternity?
In Gordon Robertson's newest DVD, Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll meet real people who have died and experienced heaven or hell. See their personal eyewitness accounts of what happens when we die.
There's more love than you can imagine.
I was comforted. I had a peace and joy I've never had.
In Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2, you'll discover a powerful tool to share the gospel with those you love, what the Bible says about eternal life, and how you can know for certain that heaven is your destiny.
I was absolutely overwhelmed by this sensation of being home.
You can have the assurance that when you die and are absent from your body, you'll be present with Jesus for all eternity.
These are not just people talking about what they think heaven is like. They've actually died, experienced it, and come back to share that, along with others who experienced hell and came back with a warning for all of us. We want you to have Life Beyond the Grave, and it is yours when you join the 700 Club. You do that by calling that toll-free number, 1-800-759-0700, or logging on to CBN.com. And right now, in the middle of a challenge, everything you pledge will be matched dollar for dollar, so it's a great time to call. Gordon?
For years, Jim and Carolyn Parker lived on credit cards. The only financial plan they had was buy now, pay later. And that plan didn't quite work out. And the Parkers found themselves under a mountain of debt.
For a long time, Carolyn Parker had her own ideas about how God blessed people.
I was going to manufacture some prosperity by using my credit cards. You get goods and merchandise, right? And long as you can pay, this was his way. This is the windows of heaven being opened to me.
Carolyn and her husband Jim began tithing when they first married. They also used credit cards to get things they needed or wanted for their growing family. Their consumer debt reached $15,000.
It was kind of depressing because it put you down, because here you are, you're making plenty of money, but you don't have any money, you know, to do the things you need to do with, because it's all going to creditors.
One day, Jim and Carolyn got a wake-up call when they couldn't pay their mortgage on time. That's when they started watching Pat Robertson teach about a system to pay off their credit cards.
Pat said, go to the smallest one and then take that amount and go to the next one. Take that amount and go to the next one. And that's what I did.
The Parkers put that lesson into practice and started to aggressively pay down their credit card debt. They also joined the 700 Club.
I love what they do. When I look at the 700 Club and the wells that they build, the Orphans Promise, Operation Blessing, the gospel is going out over the airwaves.
The Parkers finally paid off their credit cards, and not a moment too soon. Carolyn's company decided to leave the state where they lived, and she was left without a job. The company paid her an entire year's salary as part of her severance package.
That was a blessing because there were people that were being fired with nothing. And the second thing was, I didn't have any debt.
Today, Jim and Carolyn are retired, and they say they have found peace as they've learned to trust God with their finances.
God is able to supply, and He's able to give you more than what you could ever give out.
Here's a promise from Psalm 128. How joyful are those who fear the Lord. All who follow His ways, you will enjoy the fruit of your labor. How joyful and prosperous you will be. That is the Lord's blessing for those who fear Him. If you want to trust God with your finances and say, I want to turn things around, now's the time to do it. Start 2013 right and say, yes, this is going to be the year where I'm known for my generosity. I'm known for trusting God with my finances. If that's you, join the 700 Club. Be part of it. Be part of everything we're doing around the world. A portion of every gift goes into the work of CBN International to preach the gospel around the world. Another portion goes into the work of Operation Blessing to help people around the world. And if you want to do that, join with us. 1-800-759-0700. We're in the middle of a $125,000 challenge. 23 minutes, 44 seconds left on the clock. We want to go way over the top on this, and we need to hear from you. So call us now, 1-800-759-0700. When Jim Freiberg got laid off, he spent the next 2 years trying to find work. Then one day, Jim's wife gave him some advice that got him 2 job offers the very next day.
Jim Freiberg and his wife Janet enjoy their life together in Colorado's high country. Jim has always had steady work in construction, but after almost 30 years, he was laid off when the recession hit.
I just had anticipated that I would be in that spot in my life.
Janet staged homes going on the market and took a hit too. The couple went through their savings and started cutting corners every way they could. Jim searched for a job, but came up empty.
There was no apparent relief on the horizon.
Friends and family helped them get by.
There was provision, but it was humbling provision.
And then Janet had a breakthrough.
The Lord woke me up one morning with Psalm 23, verse 1. He leads you, He guides you, He feeds you. It was no longer the job is my provision. It was He is my provision.
Janet and Jim decided to trust God. They tithed off the money people were giving them and continued partnering with CBN.
Every time that we would tithe, the Lord was faithful to get us to the next spot.
For 2 years, the Freibergs continued to have just enough money to pay their bills every month, but Jim was still frustrated.
I would say, I don't think the construction industry will ever return. Janet made a suggestion to me, you know, maybe what you've been saying about the construction industry, maybe you've been, in effect, cursing yourself with your own words. And so I asked the Lord to forgive me for the words that I had spoken and to give me a second chance.
A few weeks later, the couple heard a message on declaring the Word of God.
We drove to a nearby mountaintop. We read God's promises over us, and we proclaimed and declared those promises for our life.
The very next day, Jim got 2 job offers.
Hello.
I had been working for 2 years on my own, struggling to get somebody to return a phone call to me. So God is bigger than I ever gave Him credit for. He can do things that are impossible.
He's not affected by the economy. He's not affected by anything. He's God.
Stop cursing yourself. Start pronouncing God's promises over your life. Do what Jim and Janet did and see if it won't turn around for you. That when we start thinking gloom and doom, we start expecting something bad to happen to us, that we miss out on the promise because God loves to reward our faith. Here it is, it's a wonderful promise from Deuteronomy chapter 23. The Lord your God turned the curse into a blessing for you because the Lord your God loves you. When you understand how much God loves you, how much He wants to provide for you, how much He wants to give you your heart's desire, it just gives you confidence going forward. You're not in it on your own. And when God is there helping you and providing for you, it's a great, great blessing, and it's assurance that He has your future. No more anxiety, no more worry, because you know God can do anything for you. If you want to start giving and saying, okay, I'm going to trust God with my finances, go to the phone and call us, 1-800-759-0700. What are we asking you to do? We're asking you to join the 700 Club. It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day, and you join with tens of thousands of people that want to make a difference in the world today, that want to see people help, that want to see the gospel preached around the world. If that's you, call us right now. Let's go to Christy at the phones. Christy?
Thank you so much, Gordon. And when you do partner with us, we want to give you this. It's called Life Beyond the Grave Part 2. In fact, if you count all the verses in the Bible, Jesus spoke about hell more often than He talked about heaven. Did you know that? It's true. In fact, He called it a place of weeping and gnashing of teeth. In fact, in Life Beyond the Grave Part 2, you're going to actually meet some people who've been there.
What if you knew hell is real because you'd seen it?
The stench of hell is the most rottenest thing that you can ever smell in your life.
Because you've been there.
I looked up and I saw death and I saw hell in his eyes.
How would it change the way you live your life?
I would say, I'm sorry, please forgive me. The repentance was very important.
Get the real story from people who've experienced life beyond the grave.
Simply riveting and life-changing, and it's called Life Beyond the Grave Part 2. Part 1 was so great, this is even better. And it's our gift to you when you join in the 700 Club and partner with us. So that's what we're asking you to do right now. We're in the middle of a challenge, which means that every dollar is automatically doubled, $125,000. It's doubled. How cool is that? And speaking of doubling, not only do we want to double something, we're going to triple it. Yeah, we are. We're going to give you three of these, Life Beyond the Graves, when you join in as a 700 Club Gold partner. So rather than $20 a month, that's $40 a month. So for all you partners, you're currently partners, hey, why don't you take this opportunity to take it up a notch? And speaking of taking it up a notch, there you go. We'll give you five DVDs for a 1,000 Club partner. That's $84 a month. So why are we giving you more than one? Because I'm sure there's a list of people that you've been praying for, kids, grandkids, spouses, who are kind of been straddling the fence, and you know that they need Jesus. Well, this is one of the greatest witnessing tools out there. So it's our gift to you. So join in right now. Call us, 1-800-759-0700, and we're asking you, if there's that little tug in your heart and you've been watching these stories saying, you know what, CBN really does a good job and I want to be a part of it. Well, don't wait for someone else to pick up the phone. You do it. Be a blessing to someone, and I promise you, when you do, you will be blessed in return. Gordon?
Hurricane Sandy was one of the most expensive natural disasters in American history. Many storm survivors don't even have the money to clean up what's left of their homes. And that's why Operation Blessing is in New York, bringing hope and help to those who need it.
It's been a devastating winter for the residents of Breezy Point, New York. Although Hurricane Sandy hit in late October, many people here are still without water, electricity, and basic necessities.
Pretty much lost mostly everything. The electric was underwater, all my appliances and furniture and beds, and most of the clothing was damaged.
But the people in Breezy Point haven't had to face this disaster alone. Since the first critical hours following the storm, Operation Blessing has been here, helping Breezy Point storm victims recover.
Operation Blessing had a huge trailer in our community here. Then they offered to come over and help remove the debris and the couches and the furniture and everything, because I wouldn't have been able to do any of it, you know, without the assistance.
Operation Blessing Director of Disaster Relief, Jody Geddes, says they worked on over 400 homes.
A lot of that was the gutting out and the cleaning of homes, but now we're rebuilding. We'll be taking one house at a time, two houses at a time, three houses at a time. But as we progress on each project, on each home, other people see the progress and it gives them encouragement, it gives them strength knowing that they can rebuild their lives too.
As the people of Breezy Point rebuild their lives, they will never forget those that came in their time of need.
Operation Blessing has been just another way of God showing me that it'll be okay, that we'll get through it, that, you know, what will be, and we'll be able to come back and have everything like we had it before.
That's what we want to do. When disasters strike, we want to strike back and let people know that we love them, God loves them, there's a hope and a future for them. We want to help people to rebuild. If you want to be a part of that, just join the 700 Club. A portion of every gift goes into the work of Operation Blessing to help people. Right here at home, we're feeding 3 million Americans every single month, and you're a part of it when you're a member of the 700 Club. When disasters strike, whether it's in New York or New Jersey or around the world, we want to be there and help people in time of need. If you want to be a part of that, join with us. Join the 700 Club. It's just $20 a month, 65 cents a day. When you call, ask for Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. The bank does all the work. There's no checks to write, nothing to send in every month. And because we save so much on the processing, we can send as our gift back to you Power for Life monthly teaching CDs. So if you'd like those, ask for Pledge Express when you call. Terry?
Well, camping out can be fun in the summertime, but recently I met a family who lives in a tent all year long, even in the winter, through rain and snow and temperatures that reached 20 below zero.
I'm here in Porishkovo, Ukraine, in a gypsy camp. There are 13 people living inside this tent. This is Ruslan. He's one of them. He's 7 years old. There's a two-month-old baby in here. Ruslan is wet to the core because it's a cold, rainy day here. And this little family is doing their best to make a living. You can see the dad is making baskets out of pieces of twig that he's gathered from the woods. The mom right now is out gathering mushrooms so that she can bring some food home for her children. Our goal is to build a home for them that will take them out of the cold, out of the rain, and allow them to make it through the winter and maybe even have a good life here in Porishkovo.
Working with our CBN staff in Ukraine, Orphans Promise was quickly able to put together a plan to build a shelter for this family. The most efficient and timely solution was a house made of metal with a strong wood floor and a thick layer of insulation. An airtight window and door, along with a new wood-burning stove, makes this one of the best homes in this gypsy community. And some basic furnishings and warm blankets will keep this family comfortable all winter. During my visit, we were alarmed at the condition of the two-month-old baby boy who had a terrible cough and fever. His mother was so malnourished that nursing him just wasn't enough. That day, we gave her formula and medicine for little Petro. Now he's no longer sick, has put on weight, and looks much healthier. In fact, everyone looks healthier and happier. In addition to the father's basket making, we have plans to help them with a garden or other livelihood that will bring in enough money to sustain this family.
I thank God for the help you have given us. I couldn't even dream that someone would give us such a house. Thank you.
Beyond their imagining what you did for them. These are migrant workers. They're hard workers. They move from country to country, from field to field, just getting whatever work they can and making a pittance. Not enough to survive as families. 14 people living in that tent, but you gave us the opportunity to build a home for them that will keep them warm, to give them an opportunity to feed their children, medicine to help that little one that's out there in the cold, rain, and the weather. Thank you. That's why we ask you to join the 700 Club. The power of one person to make a difference is immeasurable. You be the one today. Go to your phone and call our number, 1-800-759-0700. Say, yes, I want to be a part of making a difference in the lives of others. You'll be touching lives all across America as well as around the world. When you call also, will you say, I'd like to join and I'd like to join using Pledge Express? That's electronic monthly giving. It means your bank does all the work, but it saves us money in processing, so even more of your gift can go directly into the lives of people like you just saw living in that little camp in Ukraine. Our way of saying thank you for using Pledge Express is to send you Power for Life teachings. These are teachings we get here at CBN as the CBN family. We'd like to share them with you. You'll get one a month. And we want to say thank you. Thank you for giving. Thank you for caring. Thank you for using Pledge Express. You really are making a huge difference. Wendy?
Thanks, Terry. That was such an amazing story. And when you meet those people, your lives really are changed forever. Well, earlier, we heard from someone who went to hell. Now we want to show you someone who went to heaven and came back to tell their amazing story. Take a look.
The first thing that comes to me is he's bright. Just like John says, he's brighter than the noonday sun. And the next phrase I say, I wish people could grab it. And it's this one, and we could look at him. Everything is right. There's nothing wrong here. And I said, it's past peace. Peace past understanding. That's what's going on there. You're really experiencing the love he has for you.
Heaven is going to be so amazing. In fact, God says, no eye has seen, no ear has heard, no mind has even conceived what God has prepared for those who love him. All you have to do is believe and call on the name of Jesus and you shall be saved. If you'd like to hear more incredible stories of people who've been to heaven and seen these incredible sights and sounds, we want you to see it. It's in Life Beyond the Grave, part two, backed by popular demand. We want you to have this, and it's our gift to you when you call right now and join the 700 Club. Just 65 cents a day. 1-800-759-0700 is the number to call. Our counselors are standing by right now to take your call, or you can log on to cbn.com. It's another great way to give. Now, if you're already a member, we want to say thank you so much for partnering with us and helping people around the world hear the good news of Jesus Christ. But why not take it up another notch? It's a new year, and a lot of us need a new challenge, right? So we want to challenge you today to go to the gold level, just $40 a month. We're going to give you three Life Beyond the Graves, one for you, two to give away. And why not take it to the 1,000 Club level, $84 a month. We're going to give you five DVDs. This will bless so many people. I don't think there's another teaching that we've done that is as important as this that really could determine where you and your loved ones spend eternity. So we want you to have Life Beyond the Grave. Give us a call right now, 1-800-759-0700. Gordon?
All right, we've got a challenge, and we need to stop the clock because some CBN donors are saying $125,000 isn't enough. They want to add $175,000 to it, take it to $300,000, and we get to the end of the hour. Let's pray. Lord, we just ask for blessing for those who have made it possible to issue this challenge. And Lord, we also ask for a multiplication over it, that you would use it to enable us to preach your glorious gospel around the world. Do it, Lord, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. $300,000 on a challenge, 19 minutes and 58 seconds to go. We need to hear from you, so give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Well, while many Americans are struggling to find work, Marlene Carter had three jobs. But still, at the end of every month, she didn't have enough money to pay her bills.
If something was going to shut off, that's what I'd have to pay. If something else wasn't going to shut off, I wouldn't pay it. But the next month, it was going to shut off. So that's the kind of life I was living.
Marlene Carter's life was a financial catastrophe. She worked three jobs and still couldn't pay all the bills.
It was a juggling act.
Marlene began praying for a solution. She also started watching the 700 Club.
A lot of times after my third job, I would have to go grocery shopping late at night. And so here I'd be putting away my groceries and I'd have the television on in the kitchen and CBN was on. And I just was fascinated.
One of those lessons was giving away 10% of your income.
I remember thinking, oh my, I work three jobs and I'm still juggling my bills. I don't see how I'd be able to come up with money just to send in for a donation, you know, and it just seemed real foreign to me. But then I think that the Lord was convicting me to try it.
Marlene gave to several ministries, including to CBN, and somehow was able to make her money stretch.
A lot of times on paper it didn't make sense, and I'd heard people say that, and I can testify that that is the truth. Sometimes it's like, this doesn't add up, but it's amazing how that happens.
Then Marlene increased her giving, and a few months later, landed a new job making more than all three of her previous jobs combined.
I was really grateful. I was tremendously relieved.
And when Marlene increased her giving again, she got a promotion.
He said, test me on this, and that I would open the windows of heaven and pour out blessings more than you can contain, and it is the truth.
It is the truth. When you trust God with your finances, that's when the blessing happens. Now for Marlene, and maybe just for you as well, it seems alien, it seems strange. Why would that happen? Why, if I give, why will blessings start coming my way? It's because you're putting into practice what we here call the law of reciprocity. And it comes from Luke chapter 6. Give, and it will be given unto you. It seems counterintuitive. It seems to be against the natural way. But it's one of the principles of the kingdom of God. And it's the words of Jesus, and you can trust them. You have to put it into motion. Give, and it will be given unto you. And when you start understanding that God loves a cheerful giver, when God loves generosity, well, then you start to really understand how wonderful His principles are. We're in the middle of a $300,000 challenge. What that means is existing CBN donors love giving. They love living the generous life, and they want to challenge others to give. So they will match you over the next 16 minutes and 44 seconds. They'll match you dollar for dollar up to $300,000. And we get the red number. We're not even halfway there to the goal, $152,000 left, and we're going to take it down. Mayville, New Jersey, 2,500 club members saying, I'm doubling this year. I'm going to
Excellent.
Founder.
Thank
$5,000. Azusa, California. Chairman Circle, $10,000.
Yes.
Newport Beach, California, Chairman Circle Plus, $12,000. All of that gets matched and doubled. We're down to $120,000 with 16 minutes on that clock. Please go to the phone, join with us, and say yes. In 2013, I'm going to trust God with my finances. I'm going to trust the principles that He's put forward in the Bible. I'm going to believe. And in that way, you'll find one of the great secrets of the kingdom of God. Give, and it will be given unto you. Do it now, 1-800-759-0700. Terry?
Well, when you join the 700 Club, you're helping people literally all over the world, like this family in China. Shortly after their baby's birth, they were told to start preparing for his death.
The Zhongs were thrilled when their son Haoxun was born, until they heard that he had a hole in his heart.
When the doctor told me Haoxun had heart disease, my world fell apart.
It was our worst nightmare.
I was so worried about my brother. Every time he cried, it made me cry too.
And Haoxun cried all the time.
He could not breathe, and he would choke on his tears. I was so scared that he would choke to death in his sleep.
The hole in Haoxun's heart grew bigger, and since his poor parents could not afford surgery, they knew they would soon lose their son. Then, just as they were about to give up hope, they heard about CBN's mission to help needy children like theirs.
When CBN said they would help us with surgery, I almost shouted with joy.
This meant my son would live.
A doctor repaired the hole in Haoxun's heart and repositioned his artery. Today, you'd never know how close this precious little boy once came to losing his life.
My son is healthy and happy now. I never thought that such a wonderful thing would happen to my family.
Thank you for your loving heart for my son.
Your help healed my broken heart and made me whole and strong again.
I love my little brother. Thank you so much for saving his life.
You really did save his life. Thank you for caring. What if that was your little boy? What if you wanted with everything in your being to help him, but you just didn't have the means? Can you imagine what joy there was in that household the day that that was made possible because of your generosity? That's why today we're asking you, help us help people who are in desperate situations, who simply need a helping hand up, an arm around the shoulder, and hope for the future. That's what you give when you join the 700 Club. Join with us right now. We're in the middle of a challenge. We've got a $300,000 challenge before us. That means when you call, every dollar you give is matched dollar for dollar. Also, when you call, say, I want to join the 700 Club and I want to do it using Pledge Express. That's electronic monthly giving. Your bank does all the work, but it saves us some processing costs, so even more of your gift can be put into the lives of families like the Zhongs. So call right now, 1-800-759-0700. When you use Pledge Express, by the way, you're going to get Power for Life teachings, one every month. We think these will be a blessing to you. Gordon?
All right, we're counting down to victory on our $300,000 challenge. If we can get the red number up. We've got 107, and we're going to take it down. Amanda, Ohio, founder, $5,000.
Yes,
that takes us down to 101 with 12 minutes to go. We need to hear from you. We want to go over the top on this wonderful challenge. Counting down to victory. Boy, it's moving as I speak. 96,000 left on it. Call us, 1-800-759-0700. Well, in Honduras, many people can't afford the most basic medical care. So Operation Blessing set up clinics with free doctors and medicine. And for a baby in one village, that meant the difference between life and death.
When three-month-old Brian woke up with a cough, his mother wasn't too worried and prepared some home remedies. Hours later, Brian got worse.
He began to cough and had a fever. Then it became hard for him to breathe. I thought we were losing him, that he was going to die.
I panicked. I thought, we are poor. We don't have money for a doctor or a clinic.
That's when they remembered a clinic in another town that had medicine donated from an organization in America. But it was already late and the clinic was closed. The next morning, Maricruz raced to the clinic.
When I got there, I saw all these people, but I was so desperate, I just ran into one of the doctor's offices and said, help me, my son is dying.
The doctor quickly checked Brian and told his mother that he had pneumonia. But as soon as Brian received his first breathing treatment with medicine provided by Operation Blessing, he started to perk up. The doctor then gave Brian's mom strong antibiotics that had also been given to the clinic by Operation Blessing. Those antibiotics saved Brian's life.
The doctor told me what to do, and I gave him all of the medicine.
Within a few days, Brian was feeling much better. And when his mom took him back to the clinic 10 days later, the doctor gave Brian a clean bill of health.
I don't know how to thank you saving my son's life with that wonderful medicine. May God bless Operation Blessing.
And may God bless you if you're a member of the 700 Club because you're part of saving that wonderful baby's life. If you're not a member, join with us. Join in everything we're doing around the world. Go to the phone and call us and say, yes, I want to join the 700 Club. Number's toll free, 1-800-759-0700. We've got 85,000 left on a $300,000 challenge, and we're taking it down and counting to victory from Roanoke, Virginia, a founder plus 7,200.
Yes, thank you.
And then from Midland, Texas, a brand new donor coming in at the founder level, $5,000. That takes us down to 73,000 with 9 minutes and 42 seconds left on that clock. Go to the phone and call us, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Christy at the phones. Christy?
Thank you, Gordon. Well, a couple years ago, we produced a DVD called Life Beyond the Grave. Well, guess what? We just released part two, and people are already talking about it. Take a look.
I didn't really think much about the afterlife before I became a Christian, but after I saw the DVD, it really made me think about what's going to come and how it's going to be and what it's going to be like. I think it's good for people who are searching, whether they're searching from the standpoint of any type of religion. It's just really an eye-opening experience. I really enjoyed the fact that it really talks about firsthand accounts. You can tell in the sincerity of what they're talking about and their emotions and their feelings. This was a real situation that they experienced and they remember. I even ponder it even today, just thinking about it after watching the DVD. If you're curious about the afterlife, Life Beyond the Grave is a great source, and I believe it will provide answers to your questions. Whether you believe in heaven or hell, you will one way or the other by watching the DVD.
This DVD will change your life forever. So whatever you do, we need you to partner with us and call so we can get this in your hand. For 65 cents a day, $20 a month is all it costs. Actually, this is our gift to you. I'm just saying 65 cents a day, $20 a month is all it takes to partner with us. You know, something that I haven't done, you see those names that are scrolling by, like Penelope from Hopewell, Virginia? Thank you, Penelope. She's given us $20 a month. Thank you so much for partnering with us. Now, back to the DVD. Did you know that if you call right now, say you're already a partner, you were to take it up to the next level, which is 700 Club Gold, we're going to give you three of these. Or we'll actually give you five when you become a 1,000 Club partner at $84 a month. The reason why we want to give you a couple of these is because this is just a phenomenal witnessing tool. So that list of people that you've been praying for, your kids, your spouse, your grandkids, your whomever, this is a great gift to give to them, and this will really just show them really who God is and what he has for us. It's called Life Beyond the Grave Part 2. So this is our gift to you when you call. So remember, we're in the middle of a challenge, 57 minutes left on this $300,000 challenge. So call in or log in to CBN.com. Terry?
Well, by the end of a long day, families are hungry. Can you imagine having to face your children at dinner time and tell them you don't have anything to feed them? Angel and Myrna faced that situation almost every day after a hurricane destroyed their family business.
9-year-old Wendy took tiny bites, trying to make the small cracker last. It would be her only meal that day.
We didn't have money to buy food, and we only ate crackers. My stomach ached a lot.
But Wendy's mother was already losing hope. Myrna still cries when she thinks about those terrible days.
I knew my children were hungry. They always asked for more, but I didn't have anything to give them.
A hurricane had swept through their town in Mexico, destroying their home and their family's small ice cream cart, their only way to make a living.
I searched the flood waters for my cart, but I couldn't find it. I only found a few pieces in the river.
With the few containers they found, they made the homemade ice cream. But without the cart to keep it cold, it was hard to sell. So Angel bought a used cart that had been badly damaged in the storm.
I had no money to fix it, and we didn't have enough to eat.
Operation Blessing decided to help. First, we gave Angel new parts, paint, and tools he needed to fix up that damaged cart. Soon, the broken down cart looked brand new. Then we bought Angel a large amount of sugar, cream, and other commodities lost in the flood.
I've never imagined how much help I was going to receive from Operation Blessing. My profits had doubled what I made before the hurricane. Now I can feed my family.
I give thanks to Operation Blessing for everything they gave to us.
It is hard to find words to express my thanks to you. Thank you.
Food enough for dinner. You're providing that for families all around the world, actually, as well as right here in the United States of America. People in need. We're reaching out to all that we can, and that's why we're asking you to stand with us in that. Join the 700 Club right now. 1-800-759-0700. Gordon, you've got some good news.
I've got some great news. Waterloo, Iowa. Brand new founder, $5,000. That takes us down to $32,000 on a $300,000 challenge. We're going to take it down again. Sanford, North Carolina, a increase from a founder, $6,000. All of that gets matched and doubled. We want to go way over the top on this challenge, so give us a call, 1-800-759-0700. Well, tonight, one in seven American families will go to bed hungry. And that's why Operation Blessing is working all over America to help struggling families put food on the table.
Chris Price supports his wife and two children by working as an auto technician.
My job to me is very important. I thank God every day that I have a job.
But a recent cut in his hours has made it hard just to put food on the table. So the family is finding creative ways to stretch their budget. Chris walks 2 miles each way to and from work to save on gas. And they get food from Operation Blessing partner, Joseph Storehouse.
If I didn't have the food, I probably would have missed water or electric this month just so I could buy the food for my family.
Bob Evans is the founder of Joseph Storehouse. He says helping families is a team effort.
I don't know what we'd do without Operation Blessing. They've been such a blessing to us to bring in a variety of food. We never know what we're going to get, kind of like Christmas every once a month.
It put food in our kitchen for us, and my wife and my kids and me are very, very grateful for that. I'm glad to know that there's other people out there trying to help the people that are trying to do the best for their family.
We want to help people, and so many people in America are in need today. Operation Blessing is feeding 3 million Americans every month. Our food trucks, those Operation Blessing trucks are delivering food supplies to food banks across the nation. You're a part of that when you join the 700 Club. If you're not a member, now's the time to do it. We're counting down to victory on a $300,000 challenge, and it's been a glorious day. Fallbrook, California, founder saying, I want to increase $6,000. 2 minutes, 33 seconds left. Go to the phone and call us, 1-800-759-0700. Let's go to Wendy at the phones. Wendy?
Thanks, Gordon. And when you join the 700 Club, we're going to give you a free copy of the new DVD, Life Beyond the Grave, Part 2. It's already getting great reviews. Take a look.
This DVD definitely will uplift you. It will make you look at life a little bit differently. It was good because we're both on this spiritual journey to kind of change our lives. It was confirmation for me that, you know, there's life after the grave. The thing that I got most from Life Beyond the Grave is that I'm now, like, not afraid to die. It took my fear away because I know where I'm going to be.
And we're in the middle of a $300,000 challenge. I'm going to throw it back over to Terry.
Thanks, Wendy. You know, in many third world countries, a little help goes a long way, and it doesn't take much to support an entire family. For one man in India, all it took was a fishing net and a bicycle.
When floods hit the east coast of India, Dalai's fishing nets washed away, leaving him with no way to make a living or feed his family.
It was horrible to see our entire village submerged underwater. We lost everything we owned. My family was starving.
CBN responded quickly to the disaster with relief supplies, food, and sleeping mats.
When we lost everything, you were the only ones that helped us. You gave us what we needed to survive.
What we gave him next really put a smile on his daughter's face.
I was so happy when you gave my father a brand new fishing net, a bicycle to bring his fish to the market, and an icebox to keep the fish fresh.
Thank you so much for helping us. You gave me exactly what I needed to support my family. You have restored my life.
That ought to make you feel wonderful. If you're not a 700 Club member, get on board. We're out to touch lives and make a difference. Gordon?
All right, here's Cedar Rapids, Iowa, getting on board, saying we want to be a part of it. $5,000. Earp, California, founder, saying I want to be part of it. $5,000. And Quincy, Illinois, Chairman Circle, saying I want to go ahead this year. I'm going $15,000. All of that gets matched and doubled because we had a $300,000 challenge. It's been a glorious morning. Against it, you gave
$327.
We leave you today with these words from Proverbs chapter 28, verse 27. He who gives to the poor will lack nothing. Let that be the watchword over your life. He who gives to the poor will lack nothing. For Terry, for me, for all of us here, God bless you. We'll see you again.
Hi, this is Pat Robertson. This is an important time in the history of America. It's an important time in the history of CBN. And what you do is so very important now. But we've got to get the gospel out here in America. We've got to help the poor and the needy. feed those who are hungry, clothe those who are naked, bring medical attention to those who are suffering, and more than anything, bring hope to those who are without hope throughout the world. So your 700 Club membership makes a huge difference. And I ask you to go to your phone and call. If you haven't already called in, we appreciate what you've done so much. So don't slack. We don't want our hands to be empty. We want to say, Lord, here are those who have come to you because of my labors. Telephones are available, toll-free line, and we just thank God for each one of you. So don't hesitate to call and do it now.
I think the DVD Life Beyond the Grave will inspire anybody. It inspired me, it inspired my 13-year-old daughter, and I think that it would help anybody who doubts the reality of heaven and hell. This is a great opportunity for you to see inside a personal experience. I was reminded when I was watching the DVD that forgiveness is just a prayer away and that there's no sin that cannot be forgiven. God loves us more than we can ever know.